Hello and welcome to this video on formulation of linear programming problem. Let us take second example. A shop can make two types of sweet, A and B. They use two resources, flour and sugar. To make one packet of sweet A, they need 3 kg of flour and 4 kg of sugar. To make one packet of sweet B, they need 2 kg of flour and 5 kg of sugar. They have 30 kg of flour and 25 kg of sugar. These sweets are sold at rupees 800 and rupees 900 per packet respectively, and the best product mix so that total revenue will be maximum. So we will write this statement in the form of table. So here it is given, a shop can make two types of sweet, A and B. So here we can write sweet A, sweet B. They use two resources, flour and sugar. So here we can write flour and sugar. And in these columns, we will write kilograms of resources used. To make one packet of sweet A, they need 3 kg of flour and 4 kg of sugar. So here we can write, to make one packet of sweet A, they need 3 kg of flour and 4 kg of sugar. Whereas, to make one packet of sweet B, they need 2 kg of flour and 5 kg of sugar. So here we can write, to make one packet of sweet B, they need 2 kg of flour and 5 kg of sugar. They have 30 kg of flour and 25 kg of sugar. So this is the maximum kilograms of resources available. So here we can write availability of resources. And here we can write maximum flour available is 30 kg and maximum sugar available is 25 kg. These sweets are sold at rupees 800 and rupees 900 per packet respectively. So here we can add a column and we can write selling price per packet in rupees. So one packet price for sweet A is 800 rupees and for sweet B 900 rupees. Now after preparing this table, we can go for formulation of LPP. In formulation, we have to write objective function and constant equations. To write objective function and constant equations, we need to decide symbols for the variables. To decide symbols, we will think about these two questions. So first question is, what is objective? Objective is to find best product mix so that total revenue will be maximum. And second question is, on which parameters objective is depending? Means, on which parameter total revenue is depending? Total revenue is depending on how many number of packets of sweet A and sweet B they are selling. So we will decide a symbol for number of packets of sweet A and number of packets of sweet B. Let x1 be the number of packets of sweet A and x2 be the number of packets of sweet B. Now we have to write the objective function. Objective is to maximize the revenue. We have to write the equation for total revenue. If we are making x1 number of packets of sweet A, then total revenue from sweet A is 800x1. And if we are making x2 number of packets of sweet B, then 900x2 will be the total revenue from sweet B. So total revenue from these two sweets will be equal to 800x1 plus 900x2. So objective is to maximize Z is equal to 800x1 plus 900x2. Now we have to write the constant equations. Now constant, it is on availability of the resources. As we are manufacturing x1 number of sweet A and x2 number of sweet B, so total flour required is 3x1 plus 2x2, because 3 kg of flour is required for sweet A to manufacture one packet and 2 kg of flour is required for sweet B to make one packet. So if we are manufacturing x1 number of packet A and x2 number of packet B, then total flour required is 3x1 plus 2x2, and we have maximum 30 kg of flour. So total flour required to be used should be less than 30 kg. So the constant on availability of flour is 3x1 plus 2x2 less than or equal to 30. Similarly, maximum sugar available is 25 kg. If there are x1 number of packets of sweet A and x2 number of packets of sweet B, then total sugar required is 4x1 plus 5x2 and it should be less than or equal to 25. So, constraint on availability of sugar is 4x1 plus 5x2 less than or equal to 25. So, these are the constraint equations. Now, there is no meaning for negative values of x1 and x2. So, we can write non-negativity constraint as x1, x2 is greater than or equal to 0. So, this is the formulation for given linear programming problem. Let us take third example. A firm manufactures pain relieving pills in two sizes A and B. Size A contains 2 grains of element X, 10 grains of element Y and 8 grains of element Z. Size B contains 3 grains of element X, 7 grains of element Y and 6 grains of element Z. It is found by users that it requires at least 12 grains of element X, 74 grains of element Y and 24 grains of element Z to provide immediate relief. It is required to determine the least number of pills a patient should take to get immediate relief. Formulate problem as standard LPP. So here also we will prepare a table. So here it is given a firm manufacturing pain relieving pills of two sizes A and B. So here we can write pill of size A and pill of size B. Here it is given size A contains 2 grains of element X, 10 grains of element Y and 8 grains of element Z. So here we can write grains content per pill, element X, element Y and element Z. Size A contains 2 grains of element X, 10 grains of element Y and 8 grains of element Z. Similarly, pill of size B contains 3 grains of element X, 7 grains of element Y and 6 grains of element Z. It is found by users that it requires at least 12 grains of element X, 74 grains of element Y and 24 grains of element Z to provide immediate relief. Here we can write least grains required to provide immediate relief. So, to provide immediate relief, minimum 12 grains of element X is required, 24 grains of element Y is required and 24 grains of element Z is required. So, these are the constant minimum grains required. And it is required to determine the least number of pills a patient should take to get immediate relief. After preparing this table, we can go for formulation. In formulation, we have to write objective function and constant equation. For that, we require to decide the symbols. To decide the symbols, we have to think about two questions. First question is, what is objective? So, objective is, it is required to determine the least number of pills a patient should take to get immediate relief. And second question, on which parameters objective is depending? So, on which parameter the number of pills depend? The total pills depends on how many number of pills of size A and how many number of pills of size B a patient should take. So it depends on number of pills of size A and number of pills of size B. Let x1 be the number of pills of size A and x2 be the number of pills of size B a patient should take to get immediate relief. Now after deciding symbols for the variables, we can add the objective function. So objective is to determine least number of pills. So total number of pills will be x1 plus x2. So objective is to minimize z is equal to x1 plus x2. Now we have to write the constant equations. Now constant is on grains. A patient should take minimum 12 grains of element x, 74 grains of element y and 24 grains of element z to get immediate relief. So if a patient is taking x1 number of pills of size A and x2 number of pills of size B, then total grains from these pills will be 2x1 plus 3x2 and it should be greater than or equal to 12. So, constraint on least grain of element x. is 2x1 plus 3x2 greater than or equal to 12. Similarly, constant on least grain of element y is 10x1 plus 7x2 and it should be greater than or equal to 74. Similarly, constant on least grains of element z is 8x1 plus 6x2 is greater than or equal to 24. So these are the constant equations. And one more constant is non-negativity constant. So x1 and x2 should be greater than or equal to 0. So this is the formulation of given linear programming problem. So in this way, we can formulate any type of linear programming problem by following the steps explained in this video. Thank you.